Welcome to DIY Guitar Making at Eric Schaefer Guitars, where I share my knowledge and experience as a professional acoustic guitar maker in order to promote the craft that we all love called luthery. In this episode, I'm going to talk about the backstrip, what is the purpose of the backstrip, and what materials can we use for it. So to understand the backstrip, we have to first understand the center seam. So this is a Zeracote back here, and it's hard to tell on this example because the joint is so good, but there is a center seam that runs right down the middle of this between this bookmatched pair here. And that is where the two pieces of the bookmatched pair come together. And that joint we want to reinforce with a strip of cross grain wood. And that's what the back strip is. What I mean by cross grain is that the grain on the back is running in this direction. And so for the center seam, we need something to alternate that grain direction. Otherwise, any sort of split or anything like that that could occur at the center seam would be able to just carry right through onto that strip if the grain was parallel. But since the grain alternates, just like how the grain would alternate in the various veneers of plywood, it's that same concept here. The cross grain of the backstrip works kind of like a stitching together this potentially weak area. Now I say potentially weak because really if you do the center seam right, you really don't need a backstrip. In fact, some people, instead of having a strip that runs all the way across, they'll just put these little cleats, something like, and here I'm just gonna break this off to show you. Go a little diamond here between every brace. So if there's a brace running here, then they'd add a diamond between that brace and this brace, another diamond down here between these two braces. And even that just creates enough interruption between those braces that a split that could potentially occur there at that joint wouldn't run very far before it would meet something like this, which would stop that split. Of course, the absolute best solution is to have a strip that runs all the way the length of that seam, hence the backstrip. So what materials can you use for the backstrip? Honestly, you can use really any scrap material that you have. The cedar strip here is actually a repurposed top, cedar top, that was, its dimension was just a little bit too small. So instead of using it, I just cut it into cross grain strips to be used as backstrip material. I have a bin here where I throw scraps that can be used as backstrip material. Really anything that comes off of when I profile the plates and cut out the shape, all of that excess material around it that falls off is usually pretty good for getting those cross grain strips. So this is mahogany here, and even this will still work and really have no negative consequences to tone or anything like that. If I use mahogany instead of cedar or instead of spruce, it really doesn't matter what you use here as far as the material. I mean, I would avoid super dense woods like ebony or something like that because they're problematic with the oils anyway, but also, why do you need to add that extra density to the back? It's just not really necessary. So if you stick with something reasonably soft, like a mahogany or softer, then that's just a great choice for the backstrip. So this is one of the few areas with, as far as the parts for my guitars, that I can be a little bit opportunistic with and actually use scraps around the shop, as I mentioned before, with, you know, pulling the pieces off of the bookmatch sets, the scrap pieces. Otherwise, I tend not to repurpose scraps in guitars because I like to work with a lot of intent as far as what I'm putting on a guitar rather than scavenging things off of other things. I like to be very purposeful as far as picking out the different woods that make up the color and grain motif of the instrument. However, with the back strip, it's going to be on the inside of the guitar. It doesn't really impact the tone in any way, especially considering that it's on the back plate and not on the top. So I say use whatever you have as far as scrap wood in the shop and cut it into small strips, like you see here, with the grain running across widthwise rather than lengthwise. And there you go, you've got yourself a backstrip. If you learned something here, please give this video a like and subscribe so you can be notified when I release a new DIY guitar making video every Friday. And if you want to really learn more, take one of my structured online courses at ericschaferguitars.com or register for a hands-on guitar building workshop here with me in Burnville, Pennsylvania.